February is a monthly meeting, and so I was happy to sit with you and hear some of your concerns and some of the things that you're planning to do. And that was a great time to meet some of you. Some of you I'm meeting today, and I'm happy to do that. And just to say on behalf of the borough president, and of course you know that he would want to be here with you on such a special occasion. And I snuck in from another event because I knew that it was necessary to be here. I'm gonna be very brief, I'm gonna get right to the oath, except that I'm going to say two things really quickly. Happy International Women's Day. And as the young people say, no shame, but I don't see any women up here. No shame.
Hey.
Okay, maybe a little bit of shame. Hey. But I know that these gentlemen are gonna so serve the AAC very well. And so out there, I'm gonna ask you to repeat after me. I, state your name. Do solemnly pledge to uphold the goals, missions, and objectives of the Bronxborough Presidents.
African Advisory Council.
I pledge to perform my duties. To the best of my abilities. To support the AAC membership.
And their endeavors.
And to work toward improving. The quality of life. Of all Africans. And the Bronx community. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Distinguished guests, thank you for coming to the African Advisory Council of the Bronxborough Presidents 2018 inauguration ceremony. The AAC has been an incubator of young leaders since its creation in 2010. It's been a great honor to be elected chairman by our African community here in the Bronx. I would like to thank my wife, Haja M. Keita, for her support and for being instrumental in the electoral process. So I just want to say thank you for all your support and everything that you've done for me. The AAC has four elected positions: the chairman, the vice chair, the liaison, and the secretary. We also have six committees: arts and culture, civic, economic, interfaith, media, social committee, and there are also five different task forces: Young Women Initiative, Young Men's Initiative, the Bylaw, and the Human. Humanitarian Task Force. We understand that being community leaders come with great responsibilities, such as being great ambassadors for our communities, being law-abiding citizens, always displaying great citizenship at all times. Our aim for the next 2 years is to be more visible in our communities, increase more representation from different African communities, and educate our community with their civic duties, and register more of our people to vote. The AAC has been a great resource to our community, estimated to be over 1,000 people and growing. We want to thank the Bronx Borough President Ruben Diaz for creating the AAC, in effect giving the African community a voice in his office. We know that you care about our issues that affect us. Issues such as immigration, education, affordable housing. We stand with you in your fight and we support you. Thank you, the Bronx Borough President. We also want to thank the former Deputy Borough President, Ms. Aurelia Green, for playing a key role in the creation of the AAC, for her great service to our community for decades. We are grateful and we wish you a good and peaceful years in your retirement. Thank you. The AAC would like to say welcome to the new Deputy Borough President, Marie Scott McFadden. Welcome. We know you'll be great for our community and we look forward to closely working with you in the years coming. Thank you. This year, beyond the African Advisory Council, we'll continue to bring resources to our community and we'll continue to be strong advocates for a better life for all Bronx citizens. Thank you very much.
I can't thank you enough. Working with you has truly been a pleasure and a highlight for me because I want to see the African community succeed here in this country. You know, the council came out of some tragedies because a lot of Africans were being attacked and beaten by our own people because American blacks didn't understand the culture. And it was important that they began to understand why you are here and that you are a part of all of us. I know my roots. I know my family came from Senegal. So I had no doubt about the fact that this needed to be done. And I am so proud of you. You have truly shown that you can work together. I also said, who was it who said? You said that I said several things and gave instructions. One of those instructions was, I don't care what's going on in the continent. When you're here in the United States, in the Bronx, you have to work together. What we have to do is work collectively to build our people. And that is what I had said. And it's so important. It's so very important. And I know Marika will be working with you hand in glove as Tracy has. Tracy has been up. But I want to remind you of something. The borough president was elected last year for his final term as borough president. And he has 4 years. And I told you years ago that ultimately he would not be in office. And it was important for you to become institutionalized and get yourself together. So that you can continue the let yourselves be divided, but rather that you work collectively together. And I have to put in a pinch, because you have to involve the women. You have to involve the women. And this is your mother talking. Because we help and we are the support of our men. So I wish you all the very best.
Thank you.
I love you. I'm so proud of you. And Ambrose, tell those teens I'll be rooting for them when they're playing soccer.
I love you too.
I wish you all the very best, and I thank you so much for this night.
You have to go in.
You never know how challenging it is to do the cheer.